At Netflix, we are always looking for ways to blend art, technology, and curiosity. We spent 2 years collaborating with Production IG on bringing 4K and HDR to anime for the very first time. We wanted the sound to be every bit as powerful as the visuals.
We want our creatives and storytellers to be able to use sound in a way that they haven't before.
で、コンテを切るときも、その実際の森の音だとか、その森のその茂みの中にいる虫の気配だとか、そういうものとかっていうのをこうイメージしながらコンテを切ったりとかして、そのいかにこう実在感を伴って、なんかこう肌の質感を伴うような音。
Combining 4K, HDR, and immersive audio will absolutely bring you the best viewing experience.Dolby Atmos is an immersive audio format that I think mixers and sound designers have been waiting on for a very long time.
It's all the same tools that we've been using forever. It's just that now you have a bigger canvas to paint on. There's no more limitations on where you can put a sound. And what that ends up meaning is it opens up more opportunities for the filmmakers to give the audience a different experience that's more immersive, that's more effective.
Working on a piece that doesn't have any dialogue, there's no exposition to tell anybody how they should be feeling about something. Our job as sound designers is to craft the emotional story. We just need this world to feel big and alive and full of action and sort of fantastical to match the amazing visuals. And one of the challenges was to sort of honor some of the traditions of sound of anime and to blow it up into a cinematic level format.
When I'm mixing anything, but especially when I'm mixing in Dolby Atmos, I'm always looking for opportunities to make the mix more dynamic, make the mix have as much contrast as possible. And one of the ways I can do that is with the positioning of sound in the room. There's this great sequence where there's these fire dragons that are flying around, and the way that the director has staged it, they sort of fly almost around the camera. So we've got,You know, one that goes this way and then another comes down from above and then another one slides up from the bottom and circles around. And so having the ability to pan all that stuff through the room, it gives it this feeling like you're there on top of the camera basically and you're hearing all this stuff kind of moving around you.
When the music and the sound design can work in combination with each other and kind of can do that dance,I think that's the most powerful way you can tell the story with sound. The music has, in a way, has got to match the visuals, but it's also got to add something. The music takes us with the lead character. It shows us when she's scared, when she's having more of an adventure, you know, when she's having her rebirth. We're just musically with her the whole time.
We decided to do something different when we were capturing the score. We decided to use a Shep's ORTF 3D mic.The composer was also the conductor, and we decided to put the mic right above her. So we got all the players captured from her perspective, and that way we were able to use that audio and place it within the mix.
There would be moments like when she's transforming into her bird form. There's a big shot that's sort of from below, and she's standing up, and the brass does this really cool thing.And so I brought the trumpets out into the room and up to the ceiling as she's standing up. And so it kind of supports the movement of what's happening on the screen, but just with the music.
本当に望んでいた音と音楽にがそこに存在していました。
The director is Japanese and she doesn't speak English. It was fun, but challenging at the same time for me to translate.Her feeling and nuances and all the details into English. This is a challenge for any international production. Fortunately, the language of creativity is universal.
We always talked about everything in terms of storytelling. I never want my filmmakers to talk to me in musical terms. It's like, what do we want to feel here? What is this character feeling? What do we want the audience to feel? So as long as we're always talking about that, you know, then we're all working towards the same goal. And, you know, it doesn't matter what language you speak.
Atmos とあとエミリーさんのその音楽合わせていただいたときに、音は国境を越える というか人種も国境も超えてダイレクトに伝わってくれるってことを改めて思い出しまして、その言語だと言葉の壁があって伝わらないけれども音はダイレクトに伝わってくる。